All right, we're gonna have marinated shrimp and a couple of pasta salads.
No, Tina, no.
No, everybody likes pasta.
I feel like you're going through too much trouble with all of this.
Megan, this is your bridal shower. Of course I'm going through trouble.
Look, I think that we should just keep all of this very simple.
No, this is not gonna be simple. You're gonna have a fabulous party, a wonderful wedding. This is exactly the way Clint would want it, and it's what you want too.
I just don't feel it's right, especially now.
It is more than right. Viki and Clint would be really upset if they knew that you were backing down now, if you're holding back.
All right, fine. No more holding back.
Good. Okay, so we're gonna stick with this menu, right?
Yes, yes.
And we're gonna get a cake.
All right.
Now, the burning question is, how do you feel about naked men?
Okay, let's see. Well, why don't we just rearrange this highlight color coordinates? Why don't you go down right over there? Yeah, that's good. That fringe is just lovely. Now, let's put you in the middle. You just come down right over here. How's that,
huh? Like a French fry.
Well, you certainly don't look like one, dear. Okay. Well, this is perfect.
Heavens. Is this all you want us to do?
Oh, no way. Not at all. No, what I want you to do is to smile. I want to see those pearly whites. Like I said, I can only pick one, and the one who looks like she's having the best time gets the job. So go for it, girls. Smile.
Having fun yet?
I am. Oh, this is heaven. I'm in heaven. Oh,
hey, ba-da-da-da. Lucky, how you doing?
Hey, Court, I'm glad that you're here. Sit down. Okay. Tell me, what do you think?
About what?
These gorgeous women, what else?
I don't have time for this.
2 minutes. Come on, lady. Showtime.
I gotta get back to the hospital.
Hold on.
Lucky, what is this?
We're picking one of these girls out for Jake's bachelor party.
Come on, Clint. Open your eyes. We're waiting for you, buddy.
Sweetheart. The children are so anxious to see you. And, Cord and Tina said that they were going to try and sneak Sarah and CJ in just as soon as they could.
Yeah, and Pa's just busting at the seams to talk to you, Clint.
Clint. Darling. Come on, darling. Come back to us, please. Come all the way back to us. Sweetheart, open your eyes, please. Darling, it's me, it's Viki. Can you see me? Honey, I'm right here. Can you see me? Clint, look at me. Darling, please look at me. Can you talk? No, don't bother. Don't even try to talk. Just give me some little sign that you understand what I'm saying. Please.
Here's what to do when you don't find the rainbows in this time. Here's where you go when it looks like the rain won't end. Don't cry.
For you.
I wanted to see my dad.
Well, right now isn't a good time.
Well, why not?
Well, I think maybe another
time
father.
Would
be...
I have the right to see him.
Yeah, I know you do, but I think another time...
What's wrong? The operation was yesterday. I want to see how he's doing.
Joey, why don't you go talk to your grandmother, okay? She's right around the corner in the waiting room.
Oh, Lordy. I wish they'd send someone in here to at least talk to us.
I know, you'd think they'd realize how difficult this is, waiting and not knowing anything.
Julie,
something happened to Dad, and I want to know what it is.
Darling, there's nothing to tell you. He's in intensive care. The nurses and the doctors are taking excellent care of him, and your Uncle Beau and your mom are in with him right now.
Well, then why can't I go in, too?
Well, because...
Joey, why aren't you in school? School's out. Now, Mom said she'd leave a message for me at the office. I went there. Nobody called.
Oh, darling, I'm so sorry. I'm sure she never meant to worry you.
I want to know why she didn't call.
Well, she's got so much on her mind, Joey. Maybe she just forgot.
My mom never forgets. Now, I know you're hiding something from me. What is it?
Joey, I think that it would be best for you to go home and wait there. And as soon as I learn something from your Uncle Beau and your mom, I'll call you right away. I promise. Joey, listen.
I'm not going home. I'm not going anywhere until I know the truth about Dad. Is this better?
Much, much better. Aren't they knockouts or what?
Are you serious?
No, I'm completely frivolous. That's why I throw such great parties.
I thought we decided that we weren't going to have this particular type of entertainment.
Oh, come on, Claude. What's a bachelor party without a naked woman popping out of a cake, huh?
Naked? No one said anything about naked.
Well, not completely. I mean, there will be some spots that will be strategically covered. Anyway, everybody will be looking at your pearly whites. Right, Claude?
I'm not touching this one,
though. Nobody's touching. Nobody said anything about touching.
No, I didn't mean
it. No, there is no touch. Don't worry about that. No touching here. This is a class party with class guys.
Lucky, I thought you asked me here so we could decide how many napkins we needed or what color toothpicks to use.
Do I look like the type of guy that really cares about what color toothpicks we use?
No, I don't think you do, Lucky.
No, I'm into beauty. And aren't these the most three gorgeous women you have seen in such a long...
I'm real sick of smiling.
Don't worry. We're going to pick one out. Go ahead, Cord. Pick one.
We decided against this.
It's a bachelor party for Pete's sake, huh?
What's going on here, fellas?
Yeah, are you just wasting our time? Is this a gig or not?
Actually, ladies, the whole thing is off.
Terrific. You wasted the whole afternoon. My jaw hurts. He's smiling.
I'm sorry. It was just a miscommunication.
It was a mistake, a big one. Come on, girls, let's go.
Listen,
I don't believe
we are
this.
Gonna have a nice little party for Jake with a nice little cake. All right? It will say, "Good luck, Jake," and that is all. All right?
You don't know Jake the way that I know Jake. He's going to be expecting a little bit more than cake and champagne.
Well, he may expect more, all right? But he's not going
to
get...
I can see one of those blondes is bouncing around with just little frills on.
Look, I was there when we talked to Megan and...
That middle one, she could probably kick a leg up to her ear.
Oh, granted. But we cannot do this. The deal was we don't have a stripper and the ladies don't have some slick guy in his skivvies running around, all right? That was the deal.
Oh, Cord, how dumb am I? Here I am talking about a blonde bouncing around at a bachelor party and your father's in the hospital. Hey, I'm sorry. Really, I am.
It's okay, Luck. It's no problem.
Now, listen, I'll tell you what. I'll take care of all the party arrangements. You don't have to worry about a thing, okay? Yeah, listen, this will be a class act party, all right? It'll be just terrific. So you don't have to worry about anything.
Listen, I told you I would help you with this,
Luck. No. Listen, you don't even have to worry about it. Leave it all to me, okay? You just go back to the hospital and take care of your father. Okay, come on, go on. Go on. Go on. Get out of here.
Okay.
All right?
Thanks a lot.
Sure.
Thanks a lot.
Hey, I'm sorry to bring you down.
Oh, okay.
What was that about terrific, impeccable taste?
You do have big ears.
Yeah, and Cord has big problems. Because the only impeccable taste that you have is that you don't put ketchup on your filet mignon. Now, Cord is making a mistake here.
How do I feel about naked men?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not a prude or anything, but if you're asking me, do I fantasize about having naked men around me all the time? No.
No.
No. Well, except for Jake. I'm not going to give you any details on that either. Why did you ask that?
Because Cord and I made a promise to each other that we'd have no naked dancing men at the bridal shower or at the bachelor party.
Well, I wouldn't have dancing
naked men at the bachelor party.
No, you know what I mean. Women at the bachelor party. I just didn't want you to be disappointed.
Disappointed? I'm like totally blown away. I don't even think I'm gonna go.
Come on, Megan. I just thought, you know, it's kind of a tradition, and I just didn't want you to think you're missing out on something
Tina,
really wonderful.
Really, don't worry about it. That was the last thing on my mind. I'm actually, do you think we should call the hospital again?
Honey, we just called 10 minutes ago.
Yeah, I know. I know we shouldn't sit here and make ourselves crazy, but...
Yeah, well, thank God he stopped hemorrhaging.
Yeah, but the longer he stays unconscious, the bigger chance...
Excuse me, Miss Gordon, but I was wondering if I could have your autograph.
Blaine.
I mean, I watch your soap every day, and I want you to know I think you're really weird.
How come you're not on Twin Peaks?
Stop it.
Now, that would be the show for you.
Oh, shut up and give me a
hug. Oh, honey, I'm so glad to see you.
Blaine Adams, where have you been?
I've been around.
Been around? You should have been here, keeping me calm, telling me that I look gorgeous in my wedding dress, convincing me that there is life after marriage.
There's not! Not from what I hear, anyway.
Oh, yes, and God forbid that you should call me and tell me what's going on with you.
Well, I've been traveling.
Traveling? Could you be a little more specific?
Okay, well, I was in some out-of-the-way place contemplating my existence, and when I realized that there really wasn't much to contemplate, I tore myself away and came straight here.
Oh, what a friend. Well, I'm going nuts wondering where my bridesmaid is. She's off in Timbuktu getting tanned.
Well, I used sunscreen so I wouldn't damage my skin.
Oh, yes, well, isn't that nice? Oh, I'm sorry, Tina. This is my very good friend, Blaine. We were roommates in college.
Hi, Blaine. Hi. Tina Roberts. Nice to meet you.
If two people were any more incompatible, I'm telling you.
Incompatible? What, you like pepperoni pizza? I like plain? What was the big deal?
Blaine, we had pizza every single night. That is a big deal. Well, Tina is my mother's sister, which technically would make her my aunt, but she's a lot more than that. She's my best friend and my matron of honor.
Oh, it's great to meet you, Tina.
It's really nice meeting you. I would love to stay and chat, but I've got to go to the hospital.
Okay. So, Tina, if anything develops, you know, with Clint, let me know.
I promise.
Okay.
All right, I'll see you at the bridal shop.
Right. Take care, Tina.
Bye-bye.
I'm so glad to see you.
I missed you so much.
Gosh, you've been through a lot since you came to Landview, huh? Found out that Carrie wasn't your natural mother, that you have a whole other new family.
Yeah, and you thought final exams were bad. Well, Carrie,
sit down. Do you like your new family?
I do. I like them a lot. And so will you. I can't wait for you to meet Clint and Viki and the rest of the gang.
Well, I wish I would have been here with you when you were going through all that trauma.
Well, I'm telling you, our phone calls meant a lot.
Well, I'm glad. I'm still paying off the bills.
So tell me. I mean, what's been going on with you? What's life been like since the last time?
Oh, you know me. I was managed somehow. No, I want to know about this man.
This man? I already told you he's gorgeous and sexy and fun and smart. And...
What else could a girl ask for, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, I have a surprise for you.
Oh, please, 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 don't tell me it's some kind of live animal.
Oh, like gerbils?
Yes.
No.
Oh, Blaine.
You're still a size 8, I hope.
Yes, they're beautiful.
Mm, you always used to talk about those fantasy silk shoes you wanted to wear on your wedding day.
So. Oh, and leave it up to you to find them. Wow, I should put these on.
You've also got to let me borrow something to wear.
Oh, absolutely. Grab anything off the rack that you want.
I haven't changed in days, and I cannot stand being in these clothes one more minute. Oh, do you have a shower here?
Yeah, there's one right down the hall.
Megan, we need you on the set.
Somebody needed me on this
bed. Yeah, well, look, I gotta get going.
Would you... Can we stay here?
We'll be doing the scenes in Roxanne's apartment in 5.
Yeah, sure.
Megan Gordon, report to the set, please.
Yeah, stay here, and I'll be back in a flash, and we can gossip a little more.
But I can't wait.
Well, has he recognized anything yet?
No, not yet.
How's Viki holding up?
Well, she's holding it together, barely.
I don't know how she does it. I mean, I don't know where she gets her strength, Larry.
I think she's running on pure adrenaline. I tell you, if Clint doesn't come too soon, I'm afraid she's going to collapse.
I think he wants to be alone with her.
Well, I think you should get some rest, Bo.
No, I'll rest later.
I should go get something to eat.
I'm not hungry.
I just thought
Larry,
you
were... I'll get something to eat later, huh?
Listen, Joey was just here, and he was asking a lot of questions, and Bo, I didn't know what to tell him.
Where is he now?
He's with Renee in the waiting room.
All right, that's where I'll be if something happens, Larry.
Okay.
You're worried about Clint, aren't you?
Well, you know, medically speaking, we've done everything we can do, and what we have done can't be reversed.
Hey, big guy.
Uncle Bo, am I glad to see you. Numbi, may I get the truth about Dad?
Well, I'll give your old uncle a hug, huh?
So, how is he?
I'll tell you, Joy, he's getting the best care that this hospital can provide.
You're not answering my question.
And you're right, I'm not, because I don't know. He opened his eyes a while ago.
Well, then he's better.
No, but he hasn't said anything yet.
Oh, great, I mean, I'll go in now. Maybe he'll say his first words to me.
Joy, I don't think that's such a good idea.
Well, why not?
Your dad's been through a rough surgery. Right now, he needs some peace and quiet. Just take it easy.
What's wrong? You have to tell me. Dad's not gonna die, is he?
No. Your dad is not dying.
Joey, look, darling, I really think it would be better for you if you waited at home.
I told you, Grandma, I'm not going home. Not until I've talked to Dad. I want him to tell me himself that he'll be okay.
May I make a suggestion?
Sure.
All we're doing right now is standing around getting nervous. We can't go in and see Clint for quite some time, probably, so why don't we just go down to the cafeteria and get something to eat?
Now, there's a good idea.
We say, Joey.
Okay. I don't know.
Look, you do me a favor and get your grandma a nice cup of coffee with milk.
You don't want to come down, Renee?
Oh, I'm waiting for Asa to call, so I better stay here.
Okay. All right, great. Let's go. Come on.
Okay.
Megan, honey, listen. The wardrobe people are looking all over.
Who are you?
I'm sorry. I'm really sorry. I thought I was coming in to...
Do you always barge into a lady's dressing room unannounced?
This is Megan's dressing room,
yeah.
And...
Oh, wait a minute. Let me guess. You must be, what, the director?
No.
Producer?
No.
A figment of my imagination?
Actually, What are you doing in Megan's room?
I'm just trying to find something to wear. What do you think?
I think the other thing was good.
Excuse me, am I interrupting?
No, I just found this woman in your room, and I was wondering where you...
Trying on my favorite pink dress.
Mm-hmm.
I know.
Blaine, it looks very nice.
Thanks.
Blaine?
My college roommate.
Oh, Blaine! You're going to be the bridesmaid, Blaine.
Not only a hunk, but brilliant.
What?
Mm-hmm. This is my fiancé, Jake.
Oh, this is Jake.
Yeah, I'm Jake.
Well, he's certainly everything you described and more. It's nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you, too.
Ah, well, you better take care of my best friend here, because if you don't, you'll have to answer to me.
Oh.
Well, I'd better get checked into a hotel. Do you guys know of any good deals here in Landview?
Well, Blaine, you know, you can always stay with me.
It's us. You can stay at our place.
A hotel. You know how my crazy hours made you insane in college, remember?
Right.
Well, you know what? You try the Buchanan Palace Hotel. I got my brother is the manager over there, and I'm sure if you mention my name, he'll give you a great deal.
Well, that sounds good. Okay, well, I'll call you later, okay?
Yes.
Mwah.
Sweet girl.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, talk.
Talk what?
And don't leave anything out. I want to know exactly what went on here while I was gone.
Here you go.
Oh, hey, thank you, darling. Boy, you guys are back quick.
I didn't want him to seem dead.
Has Larry been in yet?
No news.
Joey, I've been looking everywhere for you. Why didn't you tell me you were coming here?
I don't have to tell you everything, Kevin.
No, hey, come on.
I didn't tell you because I knew you tried to stop me.
Yeah, you got that right. Mom told us to stay away from here.
I wanted to find out what was happening, okay?
No, it's not okay.
No, just relax. Take it easy. Come on, this is a hospital.
Look, Mom told you to listen to me, Joey.
All right, look, he's already here, Kevin, so he might as well stay. You're not going to mind your brother. Would you mind your uncle?
Sure.
Great. Here's what I want you to do. You apologize. Tell your brother you're sorry.
But I
said. No, buts. No buts. Just do it. All right? Shake hands.
Sorry, Kevin.
Yeah, me too. I shouldn't have yelled at you.
It's okay. He's here now. I might as well stay. Let's grab some seats and take it easy.
Hey, oh, any news?
Has Clint come out of it yet?
Well, he opened his eyes. He still hasn't said anything. He doesn't seem to recognize anybody.
Not even Viki?
No. And she is scared to death. And I don't blame her. Neither do I.
Darling, what are you doing here? You're supposed to be home resting.
I just couldn't take it. Not knowing, worrying, it's driving me loco.
Well, I am glad you're here. Because it's been driving me a little crazy, too.
Hey, Grandpa. Oh.
Joey. Shouldn't you be in school?
No, school's out, darling.
It's a good thing. Because your father would not like you to play hockey. Come here, Joey.
Clint. Look at me, please, darling. Please. Look at me, Clint. Please. Please, I need you to come out of this. All the way out of this. Don't leave me now. Please, I can't go on without you. You know what? Before we talk about anything else, you have got to tell me the end of that joke, all right? Come on, darling. I'm going crazy. I don't know how it ends. Do you remember the joke? Clint. Come on, it's knock, knock. Who's there? Orange. Orange who? Orange who?
I hate hospitals, the smells, the whispers.
Darling.
Oh, and doctors not telling anything, just leave you waiting, those nurses smiling, those empty smiles.
Hey, you know what? I got a great idea. Let's go for a ride in the country, get some fresh air, see all those beautiful new spring flowers.
Not until I'm sure Clint has made it.
Hey, we can give Larry the car phone number. He can call us as soon as he knows something.
Renee, I am not leaving.
All right, darling, but you have to promise me that if you're going to stay around here, you're not going to go storming around the place.
Who's storming? I'm standing here waiting. Will you stop worrying about me, please?
Hey, you big lug. I love you. I want you well and healthy, okay?
I love you, honey. I'm sorry I snapped at you.
It's all right. I know.
I will be okay. When Clint is okay. If he's not, I really don't care what happens to me.
Listen, we all know how tough Paul can be, right? And that he's fighting his way to be back here with us. But I'm gonna be honest with you. This has been very serious surgery. And whether or not he makes it back to us totally intact the way he was, well, that's in God's hands right now.
So there's really a chance that he could die. Is that what you're saying?
What I'm saying is that he needs us right now. His sons. To help everybody. To help your Ma, and Jessica, and Grandpa Asa, and Renee, and everybody else that doesn't have the same kind of strength that we do right now.
You can count on us, Gordy. Is that right, Joey?
Yeah. Sure.
How long has Viki been in there?
Well, not long.
Well, it's got to be at least an hour. It's more than an hour. You think she'll at least come outside and tell us what's going on?
Well, Clint has been through a very difficult operation.
No, I know what he's been through.
Well, it's going to take him some time to come around.
But how much time?
I don't know.
Sorry. I have no right to take this out on you. You've been nothing but great. Alex.
I've just been here.
Yeah, well, it means a lot to me.
Excuse me, folks.
Hey.
Anything new, Bo?
No, Vicky's still in there with him.
I don't know if you want to hear this right now, but we searched your apartment, Alex.
No, yeah, of course we want to hear it. What happened?
I had forensic go over it with a fine-tooth comb.
Fingerprints?
Only yours and Alex's.
I must have worn gloves.
We didn't find any footprints either.
You didn't?
So how this Rex character got out of the apartment is anyone's guess.
Yeah, but he did.
Apparently. It's a mystery to us. It's downright weird the way this guy can come and go without a trace.
Yes, that's what makes him so dangerous. He's so difficult to figure out.
I don't think you have to keep looking over your shoulder, Alex.
What do you mean?
Well, I've had my men do a countywide search, and they came up empty. Absolutely no trace of Rex. My guess is that he's probably left town for good.
That is good. It is.
Rafe, I really do appreciate the fact that you came here to tell me this, but if you don't mind, I'd rather not talk about Rex. Clint is all I have on my mind right now.
No.
Did you say something? Sweetheart? Did you say something? Clint?
No. Knock.
Who's there?
Orange.
Orange who?
Orange. You're glad to see me.
Oh, darling. Oh, God, you'll never know how glad I am to see you. Oh, sweetheart.
Something's happening. No, what? Just wait out here, Buster.
No!
No!
You heard what Larry said.
It's my brother in there.
I know that, but if you go in there, the whole family's going to want to go in there.
No, just out of my way, Alex, okay? I've waited long enough.
It'd be better if you just wait to hear what Larry has to say.
Excuse me, where is everybody? They're in the waiting room. What happened?
Well, it's good news. It's good news. Come on, let's
share with everyone.
Hey, Clint's regained consciousness. He seems just...
I knew it.
Yeah.
Thank you, God.
Oh, we're going to thank him so much. We thank Larry, too.
Oh, come on. Don't thank me. I didn't do anything.
Then we thank those wonderful specialists, because I'm going to send a case of the finest champagne I know.
did you talk to him, Larry?
No, I mean, he's a little shaky, disoriented. He's talking with Viki, though. He seems like the old Clint we all know.
Oh, wait a minute. It's going to take some time. It's not until he's 100%, you know. Whatever it takes.
Well, when can we see him?
Yeah.
I think he's strong enough to have visitors now.
Well, then let's go.
Yeah. Well, not all of you at once. Maybe two at a time, no more than a minute at a time, all right?
Well, who's first then?
Well, how about Joey and Kev?
I think Grandpa should go first. Don't you, Joey?
Sure, okay, it's me. Age before? Well, actually, Renee's going too, so it's age and beauty.
Feeling that, Joey, someday you are going to make a fantastic politician.
You silver-tongued little devil. Let's go, Renee.
1 minute.
We won't need that much. I just want to see my son's face. Renee?
Yep. Well, we did it. Here we are.
There's nothing to tell. Nothing happened.
Well, then why were you looking at Blaine like that?
Because I was surprised. I came in here, I found a strange woman
in
your room.
Well, you didn't look surprised.
Oh, what did I look like? Jealous, huh?
I'm not jealous.
Jealous. I can tell when you're jealous. Come on, it's ludicrous to think I would be coming on to your old college roommate. Please, this is crazy. I love you.
I just don't like women coming on to you, especially women like Blaine, especially women who are Blaine.
She wasn't coming on to me.
Oh, look. I lived with a woman for 4 years in college. She's a champion flirt.
Okay. Even if she was flirting, it's not like it happens that often, does it?
Oh, no, just once or twice a day.
Megan, if there was even the slightest bit of truth in that, who cares? I mean, it's nothing to me. Really, seriously. I mean it.
Well, do you think she's pretty?
Who?
Purdue.
Blaine.
Here we go again.
Well, do you?
What? She's okay.
The truth.
She's pretty.
Beautiful.
Megan, come on.
No, just answer me. Answer me.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I think she's beautiful. I think she has a wonderful personality, great body, if you know what I mean. And, you know, I was thinking maybe I'd dump you and go ask her to marry me.
All right, well, look, don't make fun of me.
I'm not making fun of you. I mean, it's ridiculous. There are a lot of pretty women in this world. And from time to time, I might look at one or two. I'm only human, but that doesn't mean I want to get involved with them. I love you.
Oh,
all right?
Sure. You're going to look at one or two of them every once in a while?
Huh. What is with you today? What is the big deal?
Hello? Tina, hi. Really? That's great. Yes. Thank you for calling. We'll be right there.
What's up?
We have to go to the hospital. We've got great news.
Okay.
On this day, the big difference...
Oh, I am so happy. I am thrilled. You made my day, my week, my month, my year. Please give him a big hug for me, yes. Oh, thank you for calling. Oh, Lucky, are you ready for some good news?
Always.
All right, Clint is going to make it.
All right, Clint. Way to go. You know, those Buchanans are indestructible. You know, if I had a bullet in my head, I would probably be dead
more
than likely.
Wait a second, what is this?
Oh, come on. Wanda, you must know what this is. You probably popped out of a few of them in your time. Is there a place I can hide this?
Just a minute now. You promised Cord that there was not going to be any shenanigans.
There won't be any shenanigans. There won't be one shenanigan within 10 miles of the party.
Well, what are you going to do? Have some bimbo bust out of this thing?
I beg your pardon, but I don't hire bimbos. I hire dancers.
Yeah, your dancers. Cord is not
going to
like this.
Oh, sure he will. What are you kidding? His father's well? He's definitely going to be in a mood for a party time. I mean, Jake's getting married, Clint is okay, and the Yankees have finally won a game. Huh. This is going to be a master blaster party, I'm telling you.
Yeah, well, I hope that you get the blast that you expect.
Oh, God, yesterday, I implored you to help my son. You came through for me. I thank you. I don't deserve your love. I'm not a pious man, but I'm a straight talker. And I figured maybe that had something to do with it. Sometimes I talk too straight, like the way I spoke to you yesterday. I have a tendency to be a little gruff with people. You're right, very gruff. But God, it's just my stupid way. When anything gets tough, Clint's problem was tough. Tough as I can remember. Oh, anyway, I don't want to take up any more of your valuable time. I just wanted to say thank you. And I think I'm a man who knows how to say thanks. I have to be honest. I'm not very fond of hospitals, but I sure do recognize that they do good work. So I figured some extra cash for this hospital to help other people, a wing or something. I think I best sit down to write this check. Oh, Renee. My heart is so filled with joy. Please, help me. Write this check. I'll try and sign it.
How much?
Oh, just pick out any number and multiply it twice.
How's that?
Another zero.
You are a wonderful man, Asa Buchanan.
I feel wonderful. I'm on top of the world. I have got my son back. And now I'm going home to talk to my other son. My new one. I'm going to see if Max has decided to take the Buchanan name.
Darling, I don't know that you should rush him on this.
I think he will, Renee. And if he does, everything, honey, everything's going to be perfect.
Jessica holds the bat back like this, and she swings up. I mean, how's she going to hit the ball if she bats like a girl?
She is a girl, Joey.
Yeah, I know, but that's no excuse.
Are you getting tired, Dad? Do you want us to go?
No. I'm fine.
You should see my curveball, Dad. I mean, it really breaks.
No curves. Hurt your arm.
Look, Uncle Larry said that we should only stay in here a few minutes. That we shouldn't make you tired. Come on, Joey.
Hey. How about a hug?
Joey.
I just,
What is it?
Are you really gonna be okay?
Better. Good as new.
Yes.
Hey.
Yes.
Hey, make sure they don't see
it,
okay?
Yes,
okay.
Make sure.
Shh. Hey, guys, how you doing?
Lucky.
Hey, Jake. All right, pretty good, huh? Hey, I just heard the good news about Clint.
Oh, yeah. I know. Is he great?
Oh, it's wonderful. Really, it is. Listen, I wish I could stick around and chit-chat, but I got a million things to do for the big bachelor bash tomorrow. And it's going to be a hoot, boy, let me tell you, huh? Hey, thank you, Wanda, and I'll see you later. And listen, gorgeous, I'll talk to you soon. See you guys.
See you.
Not if I see you first.
All right.
So. Talk.
That's the second time today you said.
Come out with it.
What?
What is Lucky up to?
I don't have any idea what you're talking about, sweetheart.
He never calls me gorgeous unless he's up to no good.
Well, what are you worried about?
Look, I don't want nude men at my shower. It was offered, and I told Tina no.
I'm glad. And I don't want to have female strippers running around. I think that's tacky. You know, I don't want any naked women any more than you want naked men in G-strings running around dancing at your...
Really?
Really. I mean, I think that marriage is a very serious thing, and I think that kind of stuff just cheapens it.
Good, so do I.
Yeah, I mean, the idea of a bunch of grown men sitting around drooling and carrying on
over a woman is... Yeah, it's disgusting, isn't it?
Well, yeah. Yeah, I think so. As a man, I find it very embarrassing.
Well,
I think it's degrading.
So do I, right.
Good. So we've got this settled now?
Yes.
What do you say we order something to eat, huh?
Sure. And I'm sorry about before.
Forget about it.
No, I can't. I mean, it was stupid of me to get mad at you for looking at Blaine. I mean, anybody with two eyes would look at Blaine.
That's right.
Yeah. I mean, I just love you, that's all.
Just remember, you are the only woman I want. Ever. Ever.
All right, so let's not argue.
Okay, we won't argue. Just as long as you don't tick me off anymore, we'll never argue.
Oh, shut up. Why don't you just kiss me?
Okay.
You picked a place just so it's got dancing and flashing lights.
Forget it!
Now, come on, Alex, this is a night to celebrate.
Tonight is a night for you to go to sleep.
What?
You've been up for 2 days.
So what's three gonna matter?
You need to crash. You're overdue.
Look, if I crash on the dance floor, you pick me up, put me in a cab, just tell them to take me to the hotel.
No,
no dance floor, no cabs.
Alex.
No, I am personally going to take you back to the hotel suite. I'm going to order an enormous dinner for you. Then I'm going to put you in the shower and watch you eat.
In the shower?
You're funny. Then I'm going to make sure that you go to bed for 12 hours, and I'm putting that little do not disturb sign on the door.
Well, you're leaving out one thing.
What's that?
The Chinese massage.
Oh.
You throw that in, we got a deal.
You drive a hard bargain.
No, I'm a pushover.
Well, then what are we doing standing around here?
No, what am I, nuts?
What?
I got a newspaper to run.
Tonight?
Yeah, Clint's counting on me.
Well, can I wait a couple of hours?
No. I'm going to do a whole feature on him about Clint's recovery. I'll put out a special edition on him.
But your body can't keep running on nerves. I mean, you're bound to need some sleep.
I'm going to sleep tomorrow.
Vicki.
No, darling. You really need to get some rest.
You
can't talk anymore.
I need to tell you something.
Well, you can tell me later.
No.
Honey.
No.
Honey, please.
I want you to take the cashier's check.
Oh, come on. This is really ridiculous.
And use it to pay for the machinery and end the strike.
Darling, you have to think about getting better now. I don't want
Vicki,
you worrying about business.
Please.
Okay.
Listen to
All
me.
Right. I promise. I'll do it right away. I promise.
I can't wait to get back on my feet again and get out of here and make you happy.
Oh, my darling. You always make me happy.